Welcome to the third part. And this coloring I will start with this colibri bird, and for it I will be using my favorite blue-green colors. Cobalt blue or non-photo blue are definitely in the set of my favorite colors in the whole Prismacolor range. And again I will be using apple green and light aqua to create connection between this fragment of the whole picture and other objects on this page. This is really frustrating that again I have a bird so close to the spine of the book and it's almost impossible to cover everything to color it, but my solution was to use my Faber-Castell pit pens because they are very similar in colors. Fortunately, I have beautiful green and blue pens in my stash of Faber-Castell pit pens, and they have a very thin tip, so I was able to color very close to the binding and in this way to cover all parts which I wasn't able to reach with the pencil. I also love to use my Faber-Castell pit pens as a last layer on top of pencils for creating some texture, like small feathers on the breast of the bird.
Thank you. It's almost time.
When I finished to color one fragment, I added all used pencil to my pencil stash. I have this cute pencil case in order to use in the future for other parts of this page the same set of pencils, because I really don't want to add another colors. I am trying to use the same pencils, but maybe in different color combos. My next animal is bat, and bats obviously are not very attractive and pleasant creatures. So I just concentrated on recreating their gray-brown fur, or maybe just dirty brown fur. Chestnut is interesting brown color, and I also will be using one of my favorite natural colors, which is beige sienna. According to my own rule of matching colors, I will be using exactly the same set of brown-gray pencils for this adorable creature. I am not quite sure what the exact name is, but I think that this one is very similar to the mouse lemur, and I think that it's absolutely sweet.